Are you a comic book collector, or are you planning to become a comic book collector? But of course, there's a lot of questions, a lot of different formats, and sometimes it's very overwhelming. Well, in this video, I want to give you 5 tips that will help you to stay in the game and to have joy while you're doing it. So stay tuned. The most important thing that you need to worry about to get into this hobby or to stay in this hobby, it's money. You need to understand how much money you are able to spend in this hobby. You have to budget yourself. You have to sit down, look at your numbers, so you can determine your disposable and, most importantly, your discretionary income. So the money that is left after all the bills are paid and the money that you can set aside, besides whatever you set aside for your retirement, all of those things. But the money that you set aside just in case, just to pretty much to pamper yourself. So it's important that you make that, you take that into consideration before getting into any hobby, but particularly in this hobby. Now, if you're single, perhaps you don't really have no one to really answer to whatever you do with your money. Now, if you have a family, if you're married, then you have to really talk to your spouse and really consider, you know, how much money you can spend. Of course, you always have to prepare and you put money aside for emergencies, for your for vacation time, for all those things that are important for the family. But whatever is left, that's what you are working with, and that's what you need to invest on. So whatever is left, that will determine exactly what type of collection, what type of comic books you can collect, whether they are the classic format, you want more for the collectible type, the single issues, or you want to go for the hardcover books or the softcover books. That will be determined by how much money you have left after all the bills are paid. Second thing, space. You need to have a space that is predetermined that is going to be used to collect your books. You have to have shelf space. You have to have a bookcase space. So this is something that will determine what type of collections you can have. If you have a lot of space, then of course you can collect a lot of omnibuses and hardcovers and oversized books because you have the space. Now, if your space is more limited, you live in a small apartment, or you only have a corner like I do in the back, then you have to go for perhaps for something more thin, more trim line. So you have to really be careful. So you have to know what space you can use just for your books. Now, if you're a type of person like me that collects a lot of things, so really I have to really divide a lot of things, whether it's for statues or what there is for my diecast or what there is for my gaming setup. So there's a lot of things, and most people, they have all sort of hobbies, but you need to have one specific just for books. You need to know, and that will really determine a lot of things moving forward. The third aspect you need to worry about is the format. You have to have, you have to collect the right format. There's plenty of formats. They go from digital, which technically don't take much space or no space at all, from single issues, some people love to slab, some people they just don't like to slab because they want to read the comics, single issues as they were. But you also have soft covers, you have hard covers, and there are different variations on those as well, depending on the size. Some people love the omnibuses, some people love the absolutes, and their differences. Of course, I have talked in this channel about the difference on them. But you have to have the right format. And in this, you have to determine what you like the most. How do you prefer reading your comics? If you prefer reading comics in a tablet, it's easier for you than go digital. It's really cheaper to do it that way. But if you like the old-fashioned way, then of course the single issues should be the ones you collect. If you, the soft covers are also fantastic. Epic collections, you can have a lot of collections. They're remaster editions and all of that, but they're in soft cover versions, so they're closer to the original comics. If you want something more fancy, more deluxe, then of course you go for the bigger ones, oversized, omnibuses, absolutes, and all of that. And even there, you have to choose what is best for you. If you want like a lot of collections all together runs, they go for the omnibus. If you want more particular stories, the absolutes, what produces, what DC produces, those are the best. So you have to find the format that actually you feel more comfortable with, because at the end of the day, you're going to be reading the comics. And if they're too big and you feel uncomfortable reading them, then you're not going to read them at all because they're so hard to handle. If they're too soft and you don't like the soft materials, you know, you are really, you know, really rough with your stuff, then maybe you need something more, you know, more enduring. You need the hardcover books. So you need to define which is your best format. The fourth aspect you need to consider is that you need to collect what you love. And this is one that we all falter. Most of the time we go into the hype train. We jump into it because everybody's talking about it. The next best thing that is coming up, you know, it's a pre-order for this. It's the best writer, the best script, the best art. And we just want to get the best of everything. So we jump on it. We put money on it. We pre-order or we buy it right away. And then when we read it, we just dissatisfied with it because it wasn't what we expected to be. Everybody was talking praises, but we just discover that it wasn't that great. So in that case, it's important that we just collect what we love. Of course, how do you know what you love and you haven't really read a lot of comics and you want to read comics? There's so many things you can do. In my case, for example, I do read a lot of comics that I have never read before on digital, which is cheap. You know, I don't really have to use space. I just go digitally. I read those comic book stories. And if I like them, if I think they're great, then ultimately end up buying the hardcover collections down the road, whether it's an omnibus or absolute. But already familiar with the story. Unfortunately, many of us, sometimes we don't do it. I have done the same mistake in the past and I don't do it anymore. I try not to. So don't jump on something just because everybody's telling you need to do that. If you love the 90s stuff, then concentrate on the 90s stuff. If you love the golden age of comics, concentrate on the golden age. If you love the silver age, concentrate on the silver age. You love the bronze age. If you love an artist over another, concentrate on the art of this artist. Concentrate on those things and you're going to love what you're collecting little by little, instead of just adding a lot of stuff that ultimately you're not satisfied with, you're not happy with, and also it's robbing you of really precious space that can just be the space for something else that you are going to love. So always, again, collect what you love. And final point, number 5, make a plan. It's extremely important that you make a plan. Of course, you know, there's a lot of stuff out there. Companies constantly reprint stuff over and over. They create different formats and they're just really experimenting with us so they can make more money. And sometimes we end up buying the same thing over and over and over and over again. The same collection, whether it's in softcover, whether it's in hardcover, whether it's in a different variation, we buy the same things and we all have that mistake. The problem is that, of course, it makes things more complicated. It throws everything off. Now you have to spend more money buying things to keep up with the Joneses. Of course, the space is limited. Then are you trying to, you know, you're breaking your head trying to see how you're going to, you know, pretty much fit in more stuff. And of course, you have so many different formats. So your collection looks all uneven. And definitely you have a lot of stuff you don't love in your collection. So it's important that you make a plan. You sit down and you determine, this is what I want to collect. I always advise everyone, and it's something that I'm learning, is that concentrate on the characters you love. Concentrate on certain things. Says if you want to collect X-Men stuff because you love the X-Men stuff, then concentrate on the X-Men. That's what you need to concentrate. You love Hulk? Yes. Put it aside. Don't worry about it. People are going to tell you, well, it's going to be out of print. It's going to be reprinted at some point. So concentrate on what you really care. If you love Thor, concentrate on Thor. Just try to make that little aspect, the little part of your collection fully set, so that way you can move to the next thing. Like in my case, you know, I have a lot of stuff. I love a lot of stuff, but I primarily concentrate on stuff from the 80s, stuff that I read as a kid, stuff from the early 90s. I love a lot of the Bronze Age, the early stages of the Dark Age of comics too. So I love that stuff. So I collect what I really care about. There are a lot more of the modern stuff I don't collect as much because, to be honest with you, you know, I like it, but I'm not going to say that I'm just dying out, you know, and I feel that they are a must in my collection. But everyone is different. And so you grew up in a more modern era. If you are more into the 90s or the 2000s stuff, then concentrate on those things and you're going to love it. So make a plan. And of course, that plan is going to grow. You have to have a foundation. Once you set the foundation, everything else is going to pretty much fall in place the right way. Well, guys, those are the 5 things, the 5 tips I recommend you just to follow in this hobby or any other hobby. But this hobby is very important. You need to consider the budget, your money, how much you can spend on it. You need to consider about the space. You need to consider the right format for you, the one that you feel comfortable reading because you're the one going to be reading it. And the things that you collect has to be the things that you love the most. And of course, always have a plan. So how you going to attack, you know, your collection. So these are the aspects. If there are any, let me know. What do you think about this? Are you interested in this hobby? Are you starting in this hobby? Are you an expert? Are you been in this for quite some time? You're a veteran. I would like to hear your opinion. Anything else that you think people need to consider? Let me know in the comments below. So once again, my friends, thanks for watching. God bless, and I'll talk to you again. Bye-bye.